Queensland strawberries are tonight at the centre of an interstate investigation. More Sunshine Coast grown fruits have been found contaminated with needles.
Strawberry sabotage of the most sinister kind. A needle hidden inside this sweet snack, only discovered when Erin Gelkin bit into it, pricking her tongue.
Absolutely shocked. Pretty shaken up. Absolutely abhorrent. Why someone would want to do that?
The mystery pin sending Mitchell and his girlfriend Erin for a needle of another kind.
We've had to go to the hospital, get a tetanus shot. We're also getting a blood test for her as well.
Alerting authorities, police seizing the berries as evidence.
They just took away the needle, the strawberry packet, took a photo receipt and evidence, put it in evidence bags and taken it away.
The health department investigating too.
I've contacted Queensland Health because that's where the strawberries have come from, and they're going to do their own little internal investigation, I believe.
The address for the strawberry farm on the Punnet led us here to a property owned by Donnybrook Berries, but the offending needle could have been placed in the fruit anywhere along the packaging or distribution process. Donnybrook, also one of the farms at the centre of the contamination crisis in its peak less than 2 years ago. This time purchased from an Aldi in South Australia on Tuesday, the second scare in as many days. An 11-year-old boy finding pins in his strawberries, also from the Sunshine Coast. The owner telling Nine News the contaminated strawberries aren't hers, claiming she lent the packaging to another local grower.
These are industry killers. And we all knew what happened last time.
Small, silver and sharp, they're the lingering threat, putting the livelihoods of growers at risk. The investigation into the two latest cases is in the hands of the South Australian Health Department and police. Their Queensland counterparts have been notified, but detectives will only start asking questions if credible information comes to light that links the contamination to the farms here. At this stage, it's equally, if not more likely, that the sabotage has taken place after the berries have left the Sunshine State. Jonathan, anyone caught tampering with food could face criminal charges and even jail time.
Another concerning development though. Thank you, Sophie.